Hello, did you know that the Atmega microcontroller of any Arduino can be used as a simple sound chip? In this video, I show you how to build a synthesizer with an Arduino and only a few external components. Watch my laser harp video, where I already misuse an Arduino for synthesizing the strains. Sure, most of you already know the tone function from the Arduino library. But this simply spits out a square wave, and so it sounds rather boring and always the same. But with a simple trick, you can generate any waveform with an Arduino, and with this even imitate music instruments. I talk about pulse width modulation, or PWM here. PWM is a simple method for DA conversion. For example, the audio output of a Raspberry Pi works with PWM. Here we have a digital signal with a cycle time of 16 microseconds. The signal goes high for 4 microseconds. 4 is 25% of 16, so the duty cycle of that signal is 25%. This is a pulse width modulated sine wave with 1 Hz. You see how the duty cycle changes according to amplitude and phase. The original analog signal can easily be retrieved by low-pass filtering the PWM signal, and so we can generate nice sounds with an Arduino. By the way, if you like this video, give it a thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and click the bell to never miss any of my videos. The Atmega 3-to-8 controller of an Arduino Uno or Nano has 3 integrated timer and counter units. 2 8-bit counters and 1 16-bit counter. All of these counters can be configured to output a digital signal with any duty cycle. As counter 0 is already used by the Arduino library, we use counter 2 here. And there is how the counter is being initialized. I don't want to go too deep into the details here, but let me say that I configured the counter for the so-called fast PWM with maximum frequency. That 16 MHz divided by 256 makes 62.5 kHz. In the play function, we initialize the sample array with values from any arbitrary function, like a sine wave, triangle, or rectangle with variable duty cycle. The lower the chosen frequency, the more values are written to the sample array. By configuration, an overflow happens every 16 microseconds, and an interrupt routine is called then. There we iterate through the sample array and assign the values to the output compare register of timer 2. This register sets the duty cycles of the PWM output. On an Arduino Uno or Nano, the counter 2 puts the PWM signal out of pin D11. After low-pass filtering and amplification, we get the analog signal represented by the values in the sample array. Here we have the Westminster chime as sine waves. Use sine waves to imitate flute-like tones or chimes. While triangle and sawtooth waves are suitable for string instruments. And rectangle for brass instruments. But not only the waveform characterizes an instrument. Also the way how the volume level changes over time is an important attribute. Typically, at the beginning the volume level is increased to its maximum. This phase is called attack. After that, the volume decays to the sustain level, and after the sustain phase is over, it falls back to zero during the release phase. This is known as ADSR envelope. I recommend here an interesting website where you can read more about envelopes. There you can listen to an example of a piano and a violin. A piano, for example, has a short attack but long release, while a violin has a long attack and short release. Of course, the ADSR envelope is only a rough approximation. Real envelopes are of course much more complex. So I extended the play function and the interrupt service routine in the Arduino sketch to implement the envelope. I can simply set the output volume by adjusting the PWM range according to the ADSR phase. Now playing music is very simple. Call the init function with the desired waveform, the duty cycle, and optionally an array with the envelope. In the loop function, you step through a two-dimensional array with the melody you want to play. The first value in the tuples is the frequency, the second is the duration in milliseconds. As long as the index value is within the array boundaries and the tone has finished, the subsequent tone will be played. Use the isPlaying function to peek whether a tone is still playing or not. Now let us play a little with the envelope values and waveforms. Set 20% for attack, 20% for decay, 40 for sustain and 20 for release. Note that the sum of these values must not exceed 100%. Sustain level is 16, that's 50% of the maximum volume. And here is the result. You can clearly see and hear the envelope phases. And with envelope values set like this, and triangle with duty cycle of 50%, it really sounds like chimes. A bell decays very fast at the beginning, has of course no sustain, and releases slowly. So feel free to try this by yourself. You can find the link to the code and schematics in the video description. And don't forget to give me thumbs up and to subscribe if you like. See you on my next project. Take care.